So one thing we get asked a lot here at LEA Professional is, what is the external I/O port on the back of your amplifier? And I'll explain that here with a couple slides I've got on my screen. But first, the external I/O port has three pins on it. So the first pin is for a fault status output. The middle pin is a common ground connection. And then the pin on the right is for a remote on and off control of the amplifier. So on this first slide here, I'll talk about the fault status. So this is just to give you a way to tie in an analog way to see the health status of the amplifier. So what this port normally does is it just has a pulsing 5-volt signal on it. So you can kind of see at the bottom here show if the amplifier is healthy, it'll pulse on and off with a 5-volt signal. It's kind of a half second on, half second off type of thing. If the amplifier for some reason has a fault on it, then that pulsing 5-volt heartbeat will just disappear and there won't be anything there at all. So that'll tell you that there is an issue with the amplifier that you need to investigate. So this can be hooked up to something as simple as an LED, like you can see in the picture here. You'll actually see that flash. Or you could hook it up to the GPI port of a DSP unit or a processor, or some more, sort of other piece of equipment that can handle this type of connection. So the other port we have is for remote on and off. So this is done just through a simple contact closure. So if you close the remote on-off pin to the ground pin, then the amplifier will turn off. And if you open that circuit, then the amplifier will turn back on. And this is the same functionality as actually pressing the power button on the back of the amplifier. So in the picture here, you can see we've just hooked it up. You know, you can hook it up to something as simple as a switch. You can hook it up to the GPIO port of a controller or a processor and be able to remotely control the power of the amplifier to turn it on and off. So a couple of pretty helpful pins to connect into there. If you need some external control and monitoring of the amplifier, you can do that with these two ports without going on a network connection. So there you go. Try them out and let us know what you think.